actually lived here from when I was like 6 months old till like on and off like six or seven. So yeah, I've been here quite a bit.
So I have to ask, what's it like working on one of the best looking shows on TV in that it's got one of the best looking casts on TV?
You know, it feels pretty darn good, actually. Looking at all the beautiful people on our set, and our crew is actually pretty good looking too. So yeah, it's all but a blessing, really.
Yeah, that's but it's accidental. Let's put it that way.
Working with John is probably my favorite, but it's probably the crew's least favorite because you get the least amount of work done. Yeah, it's a wild one having him on set. It's the best.
Yeah, he just changes up the energy of the air. It just becomes like we're in grade school having fun again.
Yeah, totally. He's like we have a lot of fun to work with him. Like he sing and dance, you know, like yeah. Entertain. Like even if you're not shooting, so that's great.
It's pretty cool getting to play his daughter, so, I mean, but yeah, it was pretty, pretty awesome, to say the least.
Will that make you heir to the demon, so you could become one of the next Ra's al Ghul as well?
I actually never even thought about that. Whoa, bomb dropped. Who knows? I mean, all I can think of right now is that Thea's just trying to figure out what's happening to her, or not happening to her, since she has been resurrected from the Lazarus Pit. With the all the series that have come out of Arrow, from The Flash to now Legends to, I mean, there's probably going to be an infinite number of more eventually. There's all that possibility just wrapped into it. That's the reason why we've been able to do that. And it makes it so, there's just so many options of what could happen along those lines. I can't say anything for sure because I honestly don't even know the true actual answer, but there's always hopes and options out there, really.
How long do you think Arrow can run for? We're about to go into season four. And do you think you'll stay for the long haul if Thea survives?
I mean, I hope she survives.
Come back once.
I think a month, yeah, I've come back to life once already. And I think that once, you know, she got her suit, I think that might have solidified her a bit, which is feels really nice. Yeah, I would happily stay a part of the show, and I think everybody would. We're all a pretty happy family. I think we lucked the heck out working with each other.
Arrow is a very action-driven show, so very physically demanding. How is it like to kind of cope with that, to cope with the kind of, like, the hardcore action stuff you guys gonna have to get involved with?
Well, we have amazing stunt doubles, incredible, incredible stunt doubles, and insurance clauses written into our contracts that make it so we can't do a huge chunk of the stuff that even some of us want to, but it's definitely a physical challenge at all times to keep up and to make it look like we can, you know, move fluidly in between the little cuts that we do get to do, as well as looking like we can actually are in physical enough shape to pull the stuff off. Because, you know, if you got a flab sticking out your belly, you wouldn't think that somebody's going to punch it and it'd be rock hard.
I think that the action, actually, the physical stuff is the easiest part compared to the emotional stuff. You know, having to go there, it's after doing a physical scene, I'm good. I could do that all day. But after doing one of these emotionally, psychologically meaty scenes, I'm pretty drained. I was just taking it episode by episode, but every single episode, you know, you just try to give as truthful a performance as possible. And yeah, they gave us all a lot of very challenging, psychologically and mentally, emotionally challenging moments.
Focusing on that element, what was it like in the final scenes with both of yourselves' characters on Mandipaba, when yourself has got the Mask of Katana on and yourself are fighting against each other?
You know, for me, when I heard the news that Maseo was gonna go at the hands of Katana, I mean, I thought that was brilliant. I thought that, you know, I'm a huge Shakespeare fan, and the reason why I love this show, because it parallels the profound depth of, you know, Shakespeare. And you know, that's something that happens, you know. So yeah, for me it was pretty cool.
When I heard about it, I knew it's gonna happen someday, but I had a feeling it's gonna come in, but I was really sad, and like on the set I was a bit upset before I'm actually yeah, it was a sad scene.
Mark has told me don't make any plans. I'm like, oh great, I'm gonna, you know, I think it's, well, first off, when he called me to tell me about the fact that Maceo was gonna die before, oops, spoiler, was gonna go before the end of the season, well, by the finale, he just seemed real nervous and apprehensive. I was talking to me and I was like, hey man, you know, I get the sense that you're a little nervous sharing this information with me. You know, I'm just a huge fan of the story, of the show itself. And the fact that it's been going on this long, my character has gone on this long, was just a surprise. So I knew at some point this was gonna happen. I said, well, you know, like you, I could use a vacation. So this is good news for the story and my vacation. And he says, well, don't make any plans. So
I grew up as a bit of a DC nerd, so I really had a profound appreciation for coming onto the show. And I had heard drops of the potential of anything along the lines of Speedy Arsenal or Red Arrow being like just from the get-go. And in the pilot, it was written that he said Speedy. So it was just a huge, massive Easter egg for myself, let alone like everybody else when it came out. But you know, 3 years was a bit of a long time waiting for it to happen. But I understand why it all happened that way, because of the trajectory and building up the origins. She needed to go from this point to rock bottom to build back up again, which is what they've done with like almost everybody's character, really. They've just broken them down to the point where they have no choice but to go up or to the dark, like to bring the origins of these comic book characters to life. Mm. There was that, you know, that period of time where there was just a slew of Batmans and Supermans coming out. I mean, it wasn't as many as this right now, but there was still that period of time. And if anything, people were like, where did it all go? And why wasn't it good enough?
But, you know, I think, if anything, the world in reality needs the morality tale of our superhero stories. We need that. I mean, especially with the things that are going on today. I mean, we need that sense of hope and you know, do the right thing, and wherever you can, protect people who need protecting. And, you know, it's very inspirational for me.
Yeah, it's a fairly good message to be putting out there. I mean, aside from the villains and stuff and what they're doing, I mean, I wouldn't tell anybody here to go become Malcolm Merlin and kill 503 people, but I would say, totally, you know, if you wanted to protect people, and like, I'm not saying suit up either, but people can do that in their own ways. Like, we can all stick together, be protective, and work as a human connected unit.
I mean, I love the whole costume designer's work. Yeah. From Arrow, like
she's amazing.
She's amazing. She does such an amazing job, and she also asked me, like, you know, as a point of, I mean, because I'm born and grew up in Japan, so they asked me, like, is that really, like, you know, truthful, or like, what do you think? And she researched about it, and it's really nice, yeah. And it's, yeah, I really love my costume.
Yeah. I'm so excited. Oh, like,
whoa.
We saw each other's, like, she was just finishing her fitting for the first time, and I was just about to try mine on for the first time. Mm-hmm. And I just remember seeing hers, and I was like, oh, what? No. Damn, that's going to be way cooler than mine.
And I was waiting, like, you know, after I finished fitting, I was, like, watching, like, from, like, you know.
You're watching me, like, change.
Oh,
now.
Oh, I guess.
Just pertaining to all the movies that are being made and stuff like that in the comic book world, it's also taking a side from the TV shows, because we had the Suicide Squad and these things inside of it, Argus. We were going really heavily into that for a minute. And then, I mean, something must have come down from DC or some higher up above that said, no, you must cease and desist, because we're going to make it into a movie and we can't have anybody spoil that idea. And we did get to see that little, like, pigtail and the Argus uniform and the little treat of a Harlequin, and then it just got ripped away. So if we could actually have Harlequin on the show, that'd be amazing, but it's never going to happen. I mean, I think that Thea would very much appreciate having her brother back in her life, even though she's very happy that he's running off with the woman of his dreams right now, and he's very happy, but I think she definitely needs him too. For her future in season four, man, I hope that she keeps wearing that costume as much as possible and maybe gets a yellow one with a cape or something. I don't know.
Do you think we'll see more crossover episodes with The Flash as well? Would you like to do some more?
I would love to do that stuff, but the writers love to keep us all very much in the dark, and they don't really want to tell me much about it. I mean, obviously there wasn't anything of me in season three, the crossing over, but there's a bunch of possibilities, especially now that the Legends of Tomorrow and everything like that, there's always the options and stuff. But again, I didn't even know what my suit looked like until I tried it on. And I mean, I'm just teasing about the yellow cape. I'm just really wanting it. They have not confirmed anything about it.
How far ahead do you get the scripts?
A couple of days before we start shooting. We're probably going to
get episode by episode.
Wow. And we're probably going to get, we start shooting season four, July 13th. I'm going to go ahead and ballpark saying that I'm not going to see the script till the 10th. Personally, I mean, this is all just personal opinion because, again, I have no idea what's happening in season four yet. Literally no idea other than the fact that I'm going to be in it. That's all I know. I hope that we get to see some type of effect from the Lazarus Pit. I think that would be really awesome. Some type of just whatever, whether it be good or bad. And I hope that, you know, if people are starting, I think that the stories are starting to come to a really, cool, calming end almost, where everyone's drama is kind of being resolved. So maybe there is, a period of time where everyone can actually just be happy for a second, and then it'll probably get ruined in a couple episodes, but It's been a huge arc, especially for Thea in season three. Really, going back was a bit painful for me, to be honest, because I don't blame people for typecasting. I understand it. I just felt like through a trajectory of my career, I was always typecasted as a little sister of somebody and then also a bitch for a while, or some type of rich girl wearing a school uniform. I mean, that was the exact same school uniform I wore in the UNC. It was really weird. I felt really awkward about it, but it's fine. So going back into that thing was just haven't I proven that this is not who I am? I should not be represented as that. But it was nice to be able to show.
It was an interesting contrast, I see.
Yeah, it was nice to be able to show the contrast between the two and prove that. And also to show everybody the fact that I look way better with short hair than long hair. I think, personally. Yeah.
See, there's been a lot of debate lately about the alleged underrepresentation of female heroes in the Marvel Universe and in some of the DC franchises. I'm curious for you guys how you feel about that, if you have any thoughts on that, and how shows like Arrow are going about redressing that balance.
That's actually a really good question, because one thing that makes me so honored to be on this show is being able to do a justification of this character's arc as a female and as an empowered woman. I mean, she just gets beaten down by everybody in her life, whether it be the males or the females, just everybody in her life has just been lying to her, untrustworthy, all that. And she honed into something inside of that, herself, and is becoming what she is becoming. And it's very, very amazing to be able to represent that. I think a lot of the girls on our show have been pulling that stop out really hard. Like, Katie Cassidy's character has gone through so much and now has just come out the other end like a very strong woman. And I have very high hopes for the future for women being empowered in television and in movies. I think that Harley Quinn could be a great one as this crazy, sexy supervillain, but take it away from just, her being sexy and actually just being strong and powerful. I think that's usually what should be pushed out there far more than pumping up the breasts and showing her ass. Let's actually show her mind or what she is physically capable of.
You saw the backlash against Mad Max Fury Road from a lot of people saying it was too feminist.
We've
still got a long way to go, haven't we?
I haven't seen it yet, but that made me so mad to hear that. I mean, I guess I have no, I've never seen it. I don't have any opinion on it yet, other than the fact that what is wrong with some guys out there saying that? I just don't understand how did the conversation all of a sudden just get reversed? like, what? Now there's male activists all of a sudden? Like, okay, that's fine. It's great. Congratulations.
All three of you in a battle royale, which character wins?
I would probably lose. I'm the smallest.
Well, we already know now.
I mean, come on. Of course she wins. She wins in the costume and she wins in life.
So where is Nanda Parbat? Because it seems to be about 10 minutes outside Starling.
Where is Nanda Parbat in the show?
No, it's next door. It's like a Starling City, Nanda Parbat, then Central City. You got to go through Nanda Parbat.
You know, the League of Assassins is a... it's steeped in the Middle East somewhere, so that's where it is.
Your former colleague Ben McKenzie is the lead in Gotham. Have you watched the show?
I do watch Gotham. I watch Gotham all the time. It's actually pretty crazy how many people I've worked with that are attached to Gotham now, Legends of Tomorrow, and The Flash. Like, I worked with Drew Powell a bunch of times. Dominic Purcell I've worked with. Like, just kind of crazy, awesome little small world we have up here, but. It's amazing. I ran into him a few weeks ago, actually, at the upfronts. And yeah, we were just chatting about it, how crazy it is. It's just, it's awesome.
Well, this is your third CW show, obviously, Gossip Girl, the OC. What is it about the network? It's not just yourself. Obviously, Katie Cassidy came from Gossip Girl, Supernatural. What is it about the network that sort of keeps hold of all of you, like young Hollywood actors?
I don't know. They just like to use us, and I'm not complaining about it whatsoever. I'm very happy to be gainfully employed whenever they ask for it. I mean, this is definitely my favorite thing that they've ever asked for me to do, and I'm absolutely honored to be a part of the CW kind of niche. I mean, if I fit that mold, keep me in that mold, guys. I'll take it happily.
You talked already about the importance for your characters to provide kind of interesting role models and stuff for people watching the show. I mean, Speedy appeared in one of like an iconic DC cover where he was caught doing drugs by Green Arrow and the Green Lantern. I mean, how do you work that when you're kind of working on your characters and stuff, that like these characters mean a lot to a lot of people and everything?
It's very interesting because a lot of the people come up to me and say, they like, you realize that Roy Harper was supposed to be Speedy. I'm like, yeah, that's in one of the comics, but there's also another one where Mia Deirdrin is Speedy. So, I mean, I hate to say I have done my research, and I do know what I'm talking about when it comes to this stuff. And I get, you know, people not thinking that, but it's interesting coming from the show because there's our writers wrote for the comics, and they have a huge, profound love for the stories, and they don't want us to steer away from it. But it's also difficult being on television, being on a network, and trying to mix the two together. There's definitely certain things that are gonna be lost a little bit. But it's nice to be able to pull out those stops and prove the actual stories in the pudding, I guess.
In the flashback, it was shown that you were using drugs. But and in the comic book, it was like a big deal. Do you feel that in the show, it wasn't really like given enough weight?
Yes and no. I think that the fact that they showed it was admirable enough. I respect it as a comic book lover. I am like I could take that, but I can understand people not thinking that it was enough. But the reasons why is because, again, we work on the CW. We can't just be shoving needles in people's veins and stuff like that. Like, it's just not going to happen on the network. But I think that, you know, it was nice how they brought it back around this season. They just were a nice little refresher in case, you know, people forgot how silly she was back in the day. There you go. There's a reminder of just, like, a bit of her trajectory as that. And also, yeah, I mean, it's an interesting thing. It's hard to kind of go through it, though, you know.
I think what makes a hero also very interesting is their vulnerability. That's what makes them interesting to watch, because they're, I mean, how interesting would it be if a hero was just this hero all the time? It would lose interest. So, like you said, like, they're going to do some flawed things, and you know, that's great for the morality part of the story as like a cautionary aspect of what not to do and how we can learn from it, especially as heroes.